ආරක්ෂකලේ කම්ගෝටාබේ රාජපක්ෂ මහතාගේ නාමයට කිසිදු කැරලක් ඇතිවන ආකාරයේ වාර්තා පළ කිරීමට තහනම් කරමින් ද සන්ඩේ ලීඩර් පුවත්පතේ රිව වාරණ නියෝගයක් පැනවේ. ජාතික හැඳුනුම්පත් නිකුත් කිරීම හා මික් ගනුදෙනුව සම්බන්ධයෙන් පළ කර ලිපි තුලින් සිදු වූ අපහාසය වෙනුවෙන් රාජ්‍ය ආරක්ෂකලේ කම්ගෝටාබේ රාජපක්ෂ මහතා සන්ඩේ ලීඩර් පුවත්පතේ ප්‍රධාන කර්තෘ ලසන්ත වික්‍රමතුංග මහතාට සහ ලීඩර් පබ්ලිකේෂන් ලිමිටඩ් ආයතනයට එරෙහිව නඩු පැවරූ අවස්ථාවේදී එම වාරණ නියෝගය පනවා තිබේ. ගල්කිස්ස දිසා අධිකරණයේදී අද පෙරවරුවේ නඩුවකුණු කෙරිණ.
ආරක්ෂක ලේකම් ගෝටාබේ රාජපක්ෂ මැතිතුමා සන්ඩේ ලීඩර් පුවත්පතට සහ ඔවුන්ගේ ප්‍රධාන කර්තෘවරයා වන ලසන්ත වික්‍රමතුංග මහත්මයාට විරුද්ධව අපහාස කිරීමේ නඩුවක් දැම්මා. ඒ දාන්නට සිද්ධ වෙලා තිබුණේ එතුමා කියන ආකාරයට සන්ඩේ ලීඩර් පුවත්පතේ දිගින් දිගටම එතුමාට අපහාසත්මක වන ආකාරයේ ප්‍රවෘත්ති පළ කිරීම නිසා අධිකරණය ඒක අද පිළිගත්තා.
And continue to do our job by the people, by expressing what is happening in this country, giving all shades of opinion their due place without being intimidated into silence by the jackboot of a dictatorship.
දෙකකට පෙර අප මාධ්‍ය ජාලය වෙත එල්ල වූ ප්‍රහාරයෙන් පසු යලි නැගී සිටි අප සුපුරුදු පරිදි කාර්යයේ නිරතව සිටියා. මේ දුරකථන ඇමතුමා අප වෙත ගෙනාවේ තවත් එක් ප්‍රවෘත්තියක් පමණක් නොවේ. එය අප සසල කරවන්නක් වුණා. එදා එය අප ඔබ වෙත ගෙනාවේ මෙලෙසින්.
සන්ඩේ ලීඩර් පුවත්පතේ ප්‍රධාන කර්තෘ ලසන්ත වික්‍රමතුංග මහතාට මීට ටික වේලාවකට පෙර මෙර ප්‍රහාරයක් එල්ල වී තිබෙනවා.
I do hope that one day this fight will end and his killers will be held to account. Ahimsa Vikramathunga, the daughter of slain journalist Lasant Vikramathunga, says even after 12 years of her father's assassination, who is Lasanta? Lasanta Mahila Vikramathunga was born in Kottayana, Colombo in 1958 as a member of a prominent political family. He completed his school education at St. Benedict College and did his legal education at the University of Colombo. As a lawyer, he practiced for 8 years. In the meantime, he became a member of the Sri Lanka Freedom Party and was appointed as a private secretary to the late Prime Minister Sirimavu Bandaranaike. Later, he joined with the United National Party, but he was unable to be elected as a representative of people in any occasion. Lasanta entered the journalism profession in early 80s from the Sun newspaper and very soon joined with the Island even before he became active in politics. As a journalist of the Island, he first had engaged with political reporting. Late 80s and early 90s was not healthy to journalists due to the JVP insurgence and state repression of the dissent voices. Lasanta left the country to live in Australia. The most significant phase of his journalism career had started in 1994 after his return from Australia. He started Sunday Leader as co-founder. As an editor of the paper, he created a new chapter in Sri Lankan journalism. Editorial, political column and investigative articles of the newspaper attracted the readers and made heated discussions in the country. He exposed several hidden corruption cases and disclosed the human rights violations in the country. What happened to him? Lasanta had to face several hardships and danger due to his remarkable role in journalism. A group of criminals attacked him in front of his wife. Another occasion, his home was fired using machine guns. The Sunday Leader was sealed under emergency regulations and the printing press of the paper was burned. Moreover, he and the paper were subjected to a number of court cases. Not only Lasanta, but also his family members were victims of systematic hate and unfair media campaigns. Finally, on the 8th of January 2009, Lasantha Wickramathunga was assassinated on his way to work in Athidiya, an urban area very close to Colombo. It was believed that two individuals on a motorcycle who had been following Lasantha's vehicle carried out the murder. Investigations revealed that Lasantha Wickramathunga had noted the number of the motorcycle on his notebook before the killing. The motorcycle alleged to be used by the killers was spotted at marshland in a nearby area. Mount Lavinia police launched preliminary investigations and later it had handed over to Criminal Investigations Department and the Terrorism Investigation Division. An individual named Jesudasan was arrested in 2010 as a suspect to the murder. However, he had died in remand in 2012. No other suspects were arrested until the government change in 2015. In 2015, under the Yaapalane government, the Criminal Investigations Department had started the investigation in a new round. The remains of Lasantha Wickramathunga were exhumed in September 2016 and subjected to forensic investigation, and it was confirmed that the murder had not taken place due to shooting. The new phase of investigation uncovered a connection between the killing of Lasantha and attacks on journalists Upali Thennakon and Keith Noyer. It was revealed that these three assaults had handled by a same group who had connections with the military intelligence. Accordingly, several military personnel were arrested with regard to the attacks against journalists and afterwards were released on bail. However, the murderer of Lasantha is yet to be identified. Therefore, the investigations of assassination of Lasantha has not yet completed even after 12 years from his killing, and the case is still hearing in magistrate courts. In the meantime, three senior officers of the Criminal Investigation Department who engaged with Lasantha Wickramathunga's murder investigation were removed from scene after the existing government came into power. Shani Abesekara, the former CID director, has been remanded. ASP Tissera has been transferred and Police Inspector Nishant De Silva has fled overseas seeking asylum. Although the story of Lasantha is one page of crimes against journalists in Sri Lanka, it is an overview of the process of investigations, impunity on crimes against journalists in Sri Lanka. Not only Ahimsa, but also several other family members of victimized journalists are still waiting for justice.
No other profession calls on its practitioners to lay down their lives for their art save the armed forces, and in Sri Lanka, journalism. I have been in the business of journalism a good long time. Many things have changed in Sri Lanka during that time. We find ourselves in the midst of a civil war, ruthlessly prosecuted by protagonists whose bloodlust knows no bounds. Why then do we do it? After all, I too have responsibilities and obligations that transcend my profession. And is it worth the risk? Diplomats, recognizing the risk journalists face in Sri Lanka, have offered me safe passage. But there's a calling that is yet above high office, fame, money and security. It is the call of conscience.
let there be no doubt that whatever sacrifices we journalists make, they are not made for our own glory or enrichment. They are made for you.